y double prime plus 9y is going to be cosine of t when t is between 0 and pi over 2, and 0 when t is greater than or equal to pi over 2. So essentially, we had it starting with cosine, and we're going to switch cosine off at pi over 2. First thing we're going to do is write it as one line using the unit step function. Oh, wait, new conditions here, sorry. Y of 0 is 1, y prime of 0 is 2. Okay, now we're going to write it as a one line using a unit step function. So we have y double prime plus 9y is going to start off being cosine of t, right? We want it to go away, so we subtract cosine of t times u, and what doesn't happen at pi over 2? So it's u of t minus pi over 2, okay? Now again, we cannot take the Laplace transform until this matches this. This is the trickier one that I talked about. So we have y double prime plus 9y is equal to cosine of t. Now a shift of pi over 2 is always going to turn this into its cofunction. So the cofunction of cosine is sine, right? And so I end up with this. Yeah, okay. Now, they're not always exactly right. They will turn into sine, but maybe an opposite sign. So, as an aside here, this is kind of what I think about. I think about what I have, right? So, I have cosine, which I know looks like this. Okay? It cannot change. It has to be this. Sine would usually start off right here, right? I'm going to use a different color. Sine would usually start off right here. But we're going to shift it pi over 2, which means it's going to start here, right? And do this. Now you see it matches cosine, but in the reverse order, right? So what you want to do here is change the sign out front to plus. And then when you multiply that by, you know, the opposite of that sign, it flips it over, right? And then they match up. So negative cosine is positive sine of t minus pi. Just learn that really by being careful thinking about that. All right, now you have them to match up. So now you can take a Laplace transform. So we apply a transform to both sides. We have s squared y of s minus sy0 minus y prime of 0 plus 9 capital Y of s. On the right-hand side, we have s over s squared plus 1 plus 1 over s squared plus 1 times e to the negative pi over 2s. Again, coming from that, right? And of course, now we have an algebra problem, an easy algebra problem to solve. So we're going to, you know, zoom on the y of s's. So I have two of them there. I'm going to factor out the s squared plus 9, y of s. And then you're going to have the s over s squared plus 1 plus 1 over s squared plus 1 e to the negative pi over 2s. Now, don't forget about the conditions. They're not always going to be 0, right? So y of 0 is 1. So when I plug in 1, I get minus s. But when I move it over, it becomes s, right? Minus y prime of 0 is 2. So minus 2, when I move it over, I get plus 2. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and solve. I'm going to do this on the next page. So I put the inverse on the entire page here. So let's... Yeah, okay. So if you solve for y of s, here's what we're going to have. We're going to have s over s squared plus 1, s squared plus 9, plus 1 over s squared plus 1, s squared plus 9, e to the negative pi over 2s, plus s over s squared plus 9, plus 2 over s squared plus 9. Okay? I'm dividing my s squared plus 9 all the way through there. Okay? So, we need to do now is we have to go backwards, right? So again, we're done solving it algebraically, so we have to go backwards, which means we're going to have to do partial fractions or, you know, kind of find a way around it. These two are good, right? We know these two. We're happy with these. It's these two that multiply that we have to fix. Okay. And we can do it. This is actually pretty easy to do. So, you know, you would factor the s out, then bring it back in. I'm just going to do that all at once now. We've done this enough times. I don't think it's going to be a big deal. So I have this. We have to be 1/8, right? So I need a 1/8 and a 1/8. This is 9/8. 1/8, I need 8/8, 9/8 minus 1/8, so that should be a negative. And then I'm going to bring the s back in. So we have that, right? Well, this is the same thing, so I already have this one down too, right? So this is going to be 1/8, no s, of course, right? There's no s there. So you're going to have 1/8 over s squared plus 1 plus a negative 1/8 over s squared plus 9 times e to the negative pi over 2s. And these two will stay the same. You have s over s squared plus 9 plus 2 over s squared plus 9. Okay. And again, of course, these take a lot of work on how to do the partial fractions. Okay, so once you have this, you want to take the inverse Laplace transform. So we go back here, y of t, this is going to be 1/8 cosine of t minus 1/8 cosine of 3t, right? Again, that's 3 squared. This one, remember, is attached to an e. So for this one, very quickly, I realize that we're going to have u of t minus pi over 2, okay? So when I go to this one here, remember, wherever I have t, it has to become t minus pi over 2. Well, this is sine, so it's sine of t minus pi over 2, okay? That's bad planning on my part. I didn't need nearly enough space to squeeze this one in here. I'll make it work. Now for this one, because it's a 9, I need a 3 in it, right? So I'm going to need a 1/3 out here, because this is what you're taking the transform up here, right? So you're going to have, I'm going to do that, I apologize. We're going to squeeze this in here. Let's get 1 minus 1 over 24 sine of 3, and then the t minus pi over 2, right? Yeah, this part really goes in here. And then the last two, these are easy. It's just cosine of 3t, and this will turn out to be 2/3 sine of 3t. Okay. So then you have 3 here and 3 here, right? Taking this one right here. And then I do want you to simplify. You don't have to write about it as a piecewise function, but combine the things that can be simplified here. So your final answer is really going to be this. We have 1/8 cosine t, and then this I can put with this, right? So I should have 7/8 cosine of 3t, and then 2/3 sine of 3t. I usually put all the ones without the u first in my final answer. This is going to be a solution for my first part, right? It's going to be a solution for this equation right here, right? And the rest of it, I'm going to go a little nicer now, is going to be inside the one of the intercept function. So you would have the 1/8 sine of t minus pi over 2 minus 1 over 24 sine of 3t minus pi over 2. U of t minus pi over 2. See, I need my word. I need another page here to fit on the screen. That's the U of it. That's U of t minus pi over 2.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.